let's face it, we've been there, we've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out? So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion?
Look ahead for a quick minute. We don't have the schedules yet for next year, but what we do have are the five international games that will be played, four in London and then one again in Mexico, Jacksonville, Baltimore, Miami, New Orleans, Cleveland, Minnesota, Rams, and Arizona. Those in London, and then Mexico's going to get a great game. The Raiders and New England.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And just think about the ones in London. Remember, they're splitting them between the two different stadiums in London, so they get a different flavor in all these places. But Mexico, for the second straight year, the Raiders are coming to town. That should be a whole lot of fun.
Should be a ton of fun and a very good matchup. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Now Carr. He finds Roberts complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
And here comes play number six on this drive. They come up in an offset eye. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. They give him five that time as they draw a bit closer here for a second and goal. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yes, now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
And that was a good collision right there. And I know this as a former defender. If you're playing linebacker, you're going through a checklist on every play of who you think's going to get the ball and where you think the ball's going to go. Rarely do you expect the fullback position to get it. And on that play, you did. So you've got to steel yourself at that point because the contact is going to be strong.
2 minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout. From the 3 yard line once more. Now here's third and goal. Now they'll run Murray. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost two and it brings up fourth.
Okay, offense, you've gotten down close, but it's still just the second quarter. I say take the 3 points. Plenty of game left to play.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And the 38-year-old vet able to split the uprights. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. Well, at least they won't take a goose egg into intermission as they do carve out 3 points here in the waning moments of quarter number two.
Yeah, it hasn't really been the greatest of first halves. They've looked out of sync, especially on the offensive side of the ball. But a field goal here at least gives them some momentum as we tick down toward halftime.
So the ball switches back over to Tampa Bay, and as they get set in place on offense, Charles, talk about the running game and the O-line, where they stack up going in next year, because Doug Martin was only active for 8 games this last season. Rushing total dropped down to 400 yards, basically.
Yeah, they were fortunate they picked up Jaquizz Rodgers during the year, and he gave them some nice games throughout, but I start with the offensive line. They've got some good building blocks. Left tackle Donovan Smith, guard Ali Marpet, great places to begin. I think they'll continue to try and fortify that offensive line because that will help whoever becomes their primary ball carrier.
Now, whistles and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
A dime look defensively for the Raiders on third down.
Yeah, you're right. Two extra DBs out there. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Perry Riley. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. And now here come the Raiders. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that. Super tough.
Now Carr throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice gain.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
Again, they'll throw with Carr. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On first and 10, here's Carr. Completes it right side to Cooper. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And Janikowski bangs it through. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start in the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? you adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
They come up in an offset eye. They run again on first down, Martin. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now a play fake here on first down. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this is caught inside the five. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Josh Huff. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead. And it's up. It's good. Our score, 14-6. After the touchdown, Aguayo now ready for the kickoff. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. A look at the offense now here coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Carr to throw on second down. This one caught left side by Cooper. And all the way in. Touchdown. Oakland. Amari Cooper, 72 yards. And the Raiders move back within a couple of the lead. And he showcased his blazing speed on that one.
Was he wearing football cleats or track spikes? Because he was gone. Big time play. And just think about what that does if you're a receiver on the team with him. Well, that's got to open things up for you as well, because if I'm a defense, I've got to get back deeper and deeper in order to keep him in front. But I'm not sure how many can actually keep him in front with that speed.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
I love when a play results in a game that I can actually kind of fall back on one of my favorite adages, and that is anytime there's a run over 10 yards, it means that the offensive line did its job, but you know who else did? The wide receivers. Because the first 7 yards kind of belong to the offensive line and the running back. Anything after that means the wide receivers did a great job of blocking downfield, being willing to mix it up, and give them some more space to gain additional yardage.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Evans is alone to his right. On second down, Winston again. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass.
Here I come again. Wait. Tighten up.
In motion left, that's Jackson. The play clock's running down. Play fake to Martin. Now Jameis. This is caught by Jackson. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play-action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones up to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Shift together here from the D-line. On the ground, this is Smith. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up second.
There's so many things that go into playing the position of linebacker. Some of them are actually subtle. Doing the drill work that you do all the time in practice and carrying it over to the game, get rid of blockers, and get to the ball carrier and knock him down for a loss.
One receiver to the left is Evans. Now Jameis on second down. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. Third and long for Winston. And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down. Khalil Mack able to drop him for a loss of 2, and that'll bring up fourth down. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. Fourth down, Winston. And it is incomplete. CD, wanted to get your thoughts just on the landscape of the offseason for each of these teams. Super Bowl in the rearview mirror, but so much going on. People look at the draft a lot, but there's a lot more that goes into the offseason for these front offices, is there not?
It certainly is, and even before we get to the draft, you start with the combine. You know, that's held in Indianapolis every year, and you have about 350 of the top prospects coming together to get their physicals and interviews and on-field performance, and all that will get evaluated along with their game tape. And then you got the free agents, all right? That starts, I believe, in early March, where now the free agents can start moving around to different teams. So your team's starting to take a little bit of shape there, free agency, because then the draft's coming up. You're trying to put your team together with new draft picks, have everyone start to move in one direction. And then you have the OTAs and mini camps. We get to see them on the field for the first time, and we start to get a better idea of how these teams are going to look when the fall begins.
Fresh set of downs here. On first and 10, here's Carr. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. A good convergence there defensively. Only a yard, and it's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Now Carr throwing on second down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. It's a gain of 5, and that's going to bring up a third down.
I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. Back now in Tampa. So third and 5, third and medium here.
All right, here we go. 5 and 8.
Again, they'll throw with Carr. And some room to run now. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line.
On third down, the defense decided to blitz. A very good job of recognizing it, stepping away from the pressure, and finding open space to scramble and pick up a first down.
into the red zone. It's Carr. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. And the offense moving quickly to the line.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
What a catch, and one-handed, and I'm starting to lose my awe about the play, and maybe I shouldn't. How much of this is the player? How much of it is the glove?
Well, those gloves, they do have a little grip to them, don't they?
They get that little extra tackiness to them now, and I know the guys in the NFL, the competition committee, some other places, they're talking about examining those gloves to see if they're having too much of an effect on the game.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Oftentimes, when you're not winning at the point of attack for an offensive line, maybe they're getting out physical. Spread things out a little bit, make it more of a one-on-one blocking scheme. Then you don't have to win it physically. You just have to win it by position. That may open things up for your running backs.
On the move to his left. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete.
Even though it fell incomplete, you see the value of a mobile quarterback. Great pass rush, but he was able to get away and still try to make something happen.
So they're coming up here on the 9th play of the drive, and it's 3rd and goal. Now Carr. Now they go screen. It's complete. And here he'll get it down to the 7. And the screen only good for 3 that time, and it'll bring up a 4th down.
They dialed up the screen pass on 3rd down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a 1st down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
And Janikowski bangs it through. And with that, they have taken the lead by a point here in the 4th. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know that field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
Now the Buccaneer offense set to take over again. And on that last drive, Whitford on 4th turned it over. Well, good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on 4th down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened
there. You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
They run. Martin. And he'll get this out past the 45 to the 47. Call it a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good 1st down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on 1st down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. 2nd down to the offense in search of 6 yards. Winston gives to the tailback, Martin. And they'll stop him right on the midfield stripe. Still a couple yards short of the 1st as the 3-yard gain brings up a 3rd down.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
One man on the backfield, that's Martin. In motion right is Evans. Back to throw. He's got Evans. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards on the play.
Are we really in the 2nd half here? And this is the 1st time we've seen Jameis Winston connect with Mike Evans?
Yeah, you know that they missed that in the 1st half. Up until this point, they've really missed it, haven't they?
I think that's a big reason why they're down on the scoreboard right now.
Winston with a give to Martin. And not much of a hold. Now whistles, and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Now it's second and seven. His way forward here for a good little game. Give him six on the play, and that'll bring up a third and one.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turn around and tossing it to the runner, but where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's
now the Raiders are going to use another timeout here. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. This will be play number seven on the drive. Third and a yard. They'll look to throw. Complete. He finds Brain. He needed a yard. That's what he got. And it's going to earn him a new set of downs.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Martin. And they'll give it to him here. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. An extra defensive back in the game now here for third and four. He's back to throw. And he's across for the touchdown. And it's likely the game winner here in the closing stages.
I think what we just saw in that drive, partner, is great practice, preparation, and poise. Not only did they score with little time left for them to retaliate, they chewed up enough time along the way while still getting the yardage they needed. That was an impressive drive.
Very methodical. Now, barring something crazy on the kickoff, they've got this one. After the touchdown, Aguayo now ready for the kickoff. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they're going to have really good starting field position.